All right, boys, we're literally filming this. It's 6 o'clock right now. We're just editing the shotgunning and fucking church video. Merch shop is going absolutely insane. What's sold out already? We got Steve's boot is fucking gone.
In like 10 minutes.
Carhartt collab is completely sold out. The jackets, the long sleeves, and the crew necks all sold out. The flags are sold out. The full send 500 hats are sold out. And the other checkered flags sold out. So if you guys are watching this, we literally just filmed this before the video went live. Go and grab what you want before everything's gone. Probably be gone by fucking tonight. So browse the collection and enjoy shotgunning beers in fucking church.
Yeah.
We're going to hell.
Tables turn. I don't fuck with you like when you gonna learn. They try to show me fake love, but that's that type of shit that make me swerve, 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 swerve. Yeah, that's that type of shit that make me swerve, 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 swerve. Yeah, that's that type of shit that make me swerve on them. I hit that curve on them. Yeah, they was chirping, so I went and flipped that bird on them straight up to their face. Why you tryna play? I don't got the time, bro. You fine, but you fake.
Good evening. Tonight I'm bringing you an exclusive story about faith and betrayal. Sexual abuse in the Catholic Church is nothing new, but recently I ran into two young men who have found an inspirational way to overcome their trauma.
I know this is very hard and difficult, but Kyle, would you mind telling us exactly your story of trauma?
One day I was serving. I was practicing in the back room and I was reading Corinthians 11:14, one of my favorite passages, I'm sure you know.
It's a good chapter.
And I was reading it and then I kind of felt like a slight tickle, like from behind me, like near my bum. I looked back and Father had a finger up my ass.
Father had a finger up your ass?
Yeah, I can't even remember how many times his finger was up my ass. Mm. It's almost like it's like molded.
And Steve, I understand that you have a story as well about a clergyman that abused you as well.
Okay. You got it. So, one day Father Ricky, he said, do you mind if you can get that Bible for me? Mm-hmm. And then I go and I reach to get the Bible. And then next thing you know, my sack, it's getting, he cupped it.
He cupped your sack.
He cupped it. And cupped at it. The time, I thought it was normal.
Well, thank you guys for sharing your stories. Now, I understand that you have a unique way of coping with this trauma, that you still go to church, that you haven't lost your faith, but you have something unique that you do to keep the faith.
We get slightly inebriated before and during every Mass, just because if we're sober,
yeah.
It brings back too many bad memories, especially Steve. He drinks a little more than me because he needs to be absolutely blacked out in church. Mm. Like by the time the communion comes around, this guy's got to be absolutely shingled.
So you know? I'm sorry, did I hear you right? You said you get drink in church.
Yeah.
Bum fingering and sack cupping. Kyle and Steve invited me into church just so I could see exactly how they worship.
Who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Amen.
A sign of peace. A sign of peace. Thank you. Peace. Thanks. Do you guys want a white claw? Come on.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Amen.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Oh, can't do that. That's a sin. Oh, no, no. You can't do that.
I was sexually assaulted by the clergy when I was younger.
You can't do that.
It's the only way I can get through it.
It brings back bad memories.
Holy Spirit. Amen. Obviously, what happened to you was a sin, and it's something the church
No, I'm not blaming anyone. I'm not here to cause trouble or to blame the church at all.
Okay. Drinking isn't the way to solve the problem.
No?
No, that's just going to make it worse, because then you got to deal with the effects of drinking.
He said yes.
Hey, I'll go outside.
He took our white clothes.
He did?
Yeah, he took the whole back.
Who? I'm going to say a few prayers.
No.
Can I say a few?
You can say it. You can't say prayers like that in the church.
No, it's just a white claw. It's not real beer.
It's okay.
It's a white cloth.
You're committed to sin by receiving communion and drinking like that.
No.
It's called a sacrilege. Anyway, you better leave before I call the police.
Police? For worshiping?
For doing that in church, yes.
Doing what? Father?
Come on.
No, it's because...
It's time to go. Let's go.
Shh. Oh, they don't understand. We're going to go back to the other church. We're going to go to the other church where they understand more. This is a church where they like the rape of the priests. Okay? They're sympathizing with the priests. They don't understand. Okay? It's okay. No, it is. It's not fair. They don't understand at this church. Okay?
We were sexually assaulted.
We were sexually assaulted by a member of the clergy. I was reading Corinthians 13, and next thing you know, I had a finger up my butthole, okay? That's not in the fucking Old Testament, I'll tell you that. Or the New Testament.
A messenger brought him news that he had been put to flight. That Lysias had gone.
Whoever talks, who does talk? The blind, the lame, the leper, or the one.
Which makes Christians unique for God.
That he died and rose from the dead.
Oh, shit. And that is the foundation of our faith. That if our boss himself, if our master himself.
I'm sorry.
Prepare a place for you. When I am done, I come back for you. So this is our faith. When we came, make sure we are waiting for that hope someday. May he bless us all. Amen.
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 You're late a bit. Take a call. It's just a seltzer. Okay.
Disrespectful.
I know, I have bad memories from church, so I can't do it sober, or it brings back bad memories. But I want to worship.
God bless us.
Thank you. Thank you.
The police are on the way to visit you, gentlemen.
Wow.
Drinking in front of all those people. That's crazy.
We didn't mean to interrupt the mass.
Yeah.
Yeah, but if you can at least sit in the back.
I mean, I even go in the back, and I don't.
You drink sometimes or no?
No, I never. In church.
Well, I wouldn't bring beers. It's just a White Claw. I thought it was harmless.
Yeah,
but in church,
it's a seltzer. No,
but he was sexually assaulted by a priest. Not even a priest, a member of the clergy.
Right, but that's not a priest.
It's bad.
But it's a member of the clergy.
Right, that's horrible. Like, what? Why does that relate to that, though?
Because if he's not sober, it brings back very bad memories.
You should maybe try to talk to somebody about it and try to get some help.
I still like the worship, though.
Let's get the fuck out of here.
Don't get me wrong. This is an inspirational piece, but it became clear to me very quickly that these guys were fucked in the head. I mean, the sexual trauma must have been devastating to their development. Now let's see what happens when Kyle goes into the confession.
Do I sit here? How are you?
Yeah, just seeing if there's a good amount of people out there.
I believe so.
I'm just texting someone to be like, hey, can you send some more priests?
Oh, okay. Probably have to go out tonight or something, right?
Well, there's a mass at 6.
Oh, okay.
And if I do this for 2 hours, I'm fried, man. So,
yeah.
Anyway, but you're here now?
Yep, I'm here.
So let's begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Father, my cousin.
I just want to be clear, your cousin...
My cousin.
You hooked up with your cousin, or... Okay.
My cousin.
Okay. First cousin?
First cousin.
Okay.
I checked, what's that website called? The one with the tree?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, it's my first cousin.
Did you know it was your first cousin before?
Yeah. And the sad thing, she's not even very attractive. I think it was my Uncle Tommy's birthday and he brought out some of his homemade wine. Just one thing led to another.
Okay.
Grandma was telling me to eat more bread. I should have listened to her maybe. I would have sobered up. But...
Did you have sex or was it?
Yeah. Okay. She reverse cowed me.
Okay. How long ago did this happen?
About a week.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So have you talked to your cousin at all since it?
No.
Does anyone else in your family know?
No.
Okay. Do you think your cousin will tell anyone?
I don't think so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, this is definitely bad.
Is a sin?
Oh, absolutely. It's a sin.
If it was my second cousin, would it be a sin?
I think still yes.
Really?
Third cousin, it starts to get a little bit more trickier.
Not a sin, third cousin.
I think it might even be illegal.
Illegal?
Illegal in this state.
Oh, shit. But you can't tell anyone, right?
I can't tell anyone.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
So.
Thank God. Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
So.
Thank God.
But I'm going to say, and this will be your penance, okay? So that means you have to do this.
Okay. I will. I'll do anything.
You have to talk to your cousin about it.
Okay.
So I'm not going to tell you that you have to talk to your family about it, but you have to talk to your cousin about it, about that it was wrong, that you won't do it again, and how you're going to walk forward. I'm making this your penance. You have to talk to her about
it. I will.
God still loves you.
He does? For sure?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely.
That's good. And I'll do the penance.
Yeah. But you have to talk to your cousin about this.
Okay,
God still loves you. Like, God's grace still will work.
And I love God.
I know.
Maybe I'll just spank the monkey too before family reunions next time. I'll fire up some Leela Star or something. Just in case Uncle Tommy brings out the homemade wine again. Because, you know, I don't think his grapes are truly ripe and I don't know.
Can I ask you something? You messing with me?
No.
You sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
I wish I was.
Okay.
So penance is, I'll be good if I just talk to my cousin about it and just kind of...
Make sure that it didn't
And maybe I will again. Tell. Maybe I will have to tell some of my other... My dad.
I'm not gonna make you do that.
Okay.
All I'm gonna say is that you have to talk to your cousin about how this will never happen in the future.
But I'll do what I think is right after, too, and just...
Yes.
Whatever I can do, yeah.
Yeah, all right.
Thank you, Father.
You're welcome. Can you say your act of contrition?
I don't notice
that. Oh, it's clear.
My God, I am sorry for all my sins because they displease you. You are so good and deserve all my love. With the help of your grace, I will sin no more.
Okay. God, the Father of mercies, the death and resurrection of his Son has reconciled the world unto himself and sent the Holy Spirit among us for the forgiveness of sins. Through the ministry of the Church, may God grant you pardon and peace. And I absolve you of your sins in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Okay. Thank you, Father. Have a good day. Thank you so much. That's pretty fucked up.
Truly an inspirational story from these two young men. Up next, we have a story about a young Asian man who can't seem to keep his cock in his pants. Stay tuned after this commercial break.